I get you, 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 I get As your light be appear tonight, let every darkness disappear in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your light expose every access to our future in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, our gracious Father. We pray in Jesus' name.
Can
we be seated, above? Please be seated. Once again, we welcome you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes, as you know, for Jesus, as you see, as
and on behalf of your brother and
sister, as you make my two of them, I want
to be.
I'm sorry, John, you
ask us to greet you.
Only thank you.
But the Lord Almighty will bless you indeed in the
name of God.
And it's the honor of his love over our family. We continue in the name of Jesus Christ. By the grace of God yesterday, we discovered that you can't hold the right key and not be in command. And we want to assure that we have all our own keys in that yesterday.
I want to tell you that
by the grace of God tonight, we want to discuss.
I feel so
thy word is a lamp unto our feet.
The
word is a lamp unto my feet.
For a man to go on
the way.
Especially
in night.
Papa, I need a shadow.
The light.
I need the money.
Our objective tonight, by the grace of God, is to understand the purpose and importance of the Word of God. As light in our life. Light into our path. No man can walk freely without light. And if you are walking in the darkness, such person can tumble. In fact,
to
any place or to any
roads.
So it means when we don't have the light of God in our life, we are walking in darkness. Light itself is in darkness. So therefore we need the light of God. We need the light of God. But the Bible can be our light.
Bíbélì sọ nípa ayé wọn fún
àǹtí. Ìmọ̀lẹ̀ sí ayé
wọn. Bíbélì the Bible is a light to our
life. The Bible can be our light.
Okay, the Bible, ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run lè jẹ́ ìmọ̀lẹ̀ sí ayé.
Show us the way ahead.
Láti lè fi ọ̀nà hàn wá síwájú.
So that we won't fall or
Kí a má bàa ṣíbí.
And I pray for someone tonight.
Mo gbàdúrà fún ẹnìkan
ní àṣà. The perpetual light of God will shine upon your life. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Ìmọ̀lẹ̀ Ọlọ́run máa tẹ̀síwájú.
If I'm talking to you, say a better amen.
Kí n bá ti ń gbàdúrà máa
sọ. I say the light of God will shine into your life. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Ìmọ̀lẹ̀ Ọlọ́run máa tọ̀ sí ayé yín.
Let us open to Psalm 119.
Psalm 119.
And we want to read Psalm 105.
Afeka ese ogbonu eleko.
Text 105.
Okay, ogbonu elemanu.
Text 105. The Lord is a lamp to my guide, my feet, and a light for my path.
Only ọ̀rọ̀rẹ́ ni fìfílà sí ọkàn mi. Ọ̀rọ̀rẹ́ ni fìfílà fún ẹsẹ̀ mi àti ìmọ̀lẹ̀ sí ọ̀rọ̀ mi.
It means even the Bible understands what the bubbles and the buttons of light into our life.
Ó jẹ́ wípé Bíbélì pàápàá. Ó mọ̀ dájúdájú pé bí ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ṣe
pàtàkì. So therefore, no man can walk without the light of God.
Ẹni tó lè rìn láì sí ìmọ̀lẹ̀ Ọlọ́run.
Whoever that is going to walk with the light of God.
Ẹni tó bá rìn nípa ìmọ̀lẹ̀ Ọlọ́run.
That person can stumble.
Ẹni yẹn ó lè kọsẹ̀.
Such person can fall.
Ó lè ṣubú pátápátá.
And such person may not be able to achieve what he has planned to achieve.
Ẹni náà ó lè má lè ṣe àṣeyọrí.
The word of God is a lamp for our feet.
Fìfílà sí ẹsẹ̀ wa.
The Bible says your word is the lamp to guide my feet.
Ó ní ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ ní fìfílà láti tọ́ ẹsẹ̀ mi.
And a light for my path.
Òun náà ní fìfílà sí orí ìmọ́lẹ̀ sí ẹsẹ̀ mi sí ọ̀nà mi.
If the Lord is your lamp.
Tí Ọlọ́run bá jẹ́ ìmọ́lẹ̀ rẹ.
And the Lord is your light.
Tí Ọlọ́run jẹ́ ẹni tó ń tọ́.
You have no fear.
O kò nílò láti
rẹ̀. Even when you are working in darkness.
Tí o bá tilẹ̀ ń rìn nínú òkùnkùn pàápàá.
Quickly let us see what is the lamp to our feet.
Ẹ ká wo ohun tó jẹ́ pé tó
jẹ́. What is the lamp to our feet?
Àtùpà
sí ẹsẹ̀ wa. Kí ni ìmọ̀lẹ̀ jẹ́ nínú
ìwọ̀n?
What is the lamp to our feet? Lamp is an object that produces light.
Wọ́n ní ìmọ̀lẹ̀ ni ohun tó ń fa ìmọ̀lẹ̀ tó ń lò.
Lamp is an object that produces light.
Àtùpà yẹn ó jẹ́ ohun tó mú ìmọ́lẹ̀ wá.
And the word of God is a lamp to our feet.
Ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run dẹ̀ ni àtùpà yẹn sí.
Which side?
Èyí tó tọ̀ sí ipa ọ̀nà ibi tá à ń rìn.
So that we may not stop.
Kí a má bàa ṣubú kí a má
bàa. And we may see the path and danger in the path.
Kí a lè rí ọ̀nà náà àti ewu tó wà nínú ọ̀nà.
It is not possible for any man or woman.
Fún ọkùnrin àbí obìnrin.
Even when you are talking. Night.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ bá tilẹ̀ ń rìnrìn àjò ní àṣà
ní alẹ́. And we are
falling in the darkness.
Fẹ́ ń rú without light.
Láì sí ìmọ́lẹ̀.
Two things will happen.
Ohun méjì ló máa ṣẹlẹ̀.
That person will not be able to go far.
Ẹni yẹn lè má lè rìn jìnnà.
And if it is trying to manage to go.
Tó bá tilẹ̀ ń gbìyànjú láti máa lọ.
He will not be able to go as far as it is.
Òní lè rìn síwájú dáradára.
Because he didn't have the opportunity or the grace to see ahead.
Òní ní orí ọ̀fẹ́ láti rí ohun tó ń bẹ níwájú rẹ̀.
When you are going with your life.
Ṣùgbọ́n nígbà tó máa ń lọ pẹ̀lú àtùpà.
When you are in the darkness.
Tó wà nínú òkùnkùn.
The darkness will disappear.
Òkùnkùn á pòórá.
When the moment the light appear.
Bí ìmọ̀lẹ̀ bá ti farahàn.
The darkness will disappear.
Òkùnkùn á farajà.
The Bible says the lamp, the word of God is a lamp to our feet.
Bíbélì sọ pé ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ni àtùpà yẹn sí ẹsẹ̀ wa.
Where is the light to guide us?
Òun ni ìmọ̀lẹ̀ láti ṣọwá
sọ. When we are going in the darkness.
Nígbà tá a bá ń lọ nínú òkùnkùn.
We have no nothing to fear.
A kò nílò láti.
Because it will set light into our way.
Nítorí pé ìbálẹ̀ fi wà níjọ.
The word of God is a lamp to our feet.
Ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ò ní àtùpà.
And also into our path.
Ọlọ́run ni.
So in the life of a woman every month.
Ìgbé ayé ẹnìkan.
Nínú ìgbé ayé ẹnìkọ̀ọ̀kan wa pátápátá.
Ìgbé ayé ẹnìkọ̀ọ̀kan wa.
If you don't have the light of God in you.
Ká fẹ́ tó bá. Let
me pray and let you know that you are walking in darkness. And whoever that is working in darkness,
any kind of man in your people,
such person will not be able to go. So only you allow the light of God to shine in your
life. Number two, okay,
the purpose of the light of God in our life is for preservation from perils of enemies. If you look at Psalm 119, where we read,
Trust 109 to 110.
My life constantly hangs in the balance, but I will not stop obeying your instruction. The wicked have set their trap for me, but I will not turn from your commandments. The word of God is preserve me from the hands of enemies. You will preserve me from the hands of
enemies.
And the moment the light appears, darkness has no option than to disappear. And when the darkness disappears, the word of God reappears. And when the word of God appears, the presence of God will take place. And tonight, by the grace of God, What does he mean? To set us apart.
That is,
as we dedicate ourselves to God, God will set us apart.
Allah,
us
even from evil ways. Even from the
finger of the
best
times.
And the last but not the least for that one.
To
educate us.
That's the core one.
To educate us. Psalm 119, verse 108.
119,
verse 108. Accept my offering of praise. And teach me your regulations.
Only for the open so they call me a caller.
Teach your regulations. And teach me your regulations. Teach us what to do.
Teach
us what we're supposed to know. And to teach us the way of the Lord. The word of God is a light. And the light of that darkness. And the space is access. I
could
remember those days when we were much younger than this. Our mother normally used. We call it lantern. Yes, lantern.
Achupa.
Yes, achupa. And the moment the lamp of that lantern. The places above, somewhere and above. And as small as that lantern it is,
it
will set light into that room.
And
but when you light up your lantern, and put it under your bed,
it
can see it didn't do anything. So also the word of God for you.
What
you say is the life to our feet.
Only
and when is signing your feet. Your feet do not stumble. I pray for you tonight.
Do
not stumble in the name of Jesus Christ. Okay, let's examine the importance of the word of God and light into our feet. Importance of the word of God as light into our feet. It is your medicine for
illness.
It is your medicine for healing. And weapon for deliverance.
It
sent out his word. And the word is there. The word of God as light. Into our feet is our healings,
our
medicines. So if anyone is going in life without the light of God,
we will not be healed.
And that person can stumble. And you find us to get your destination. But because you have the word of God in your life tonight, you will surely get here in the name of Jesus Christ. It's your light for illuminations.
This
is your light for illuminations. And directions.
That
is saying we direct you and guide you.
We
give you his ways. Make his way to be part of your lives. It's also a weapon for our victory. I wonder why all you want to be lame, all you want to call yourself a winner. The word of God in your life. As big as this Bible is,
people
respect it. What the people respect is the word of God in our hearts. The word of God is a weapon to our victories. When you have it in your heart, in your mind, you can be simply be victorious. I speak into someone like tonight. As you have that word of God in your life,
be
victorious in the name of Jesus Christ. Lastly, is your key to good access. The word of God is your key to good access. Your key to good success. If you don't have the word of God in your life, you
will
find it difficult to succeed. God is the only
rule.
The only rule we have in our life is the word of God.
I want
to make a call tonight.
November in
that the word of God in your life.
And you are alone.
So when the temptation comes,
see that he don't obey.
When the temptation comes,
see that he don't obey.
The professor said, he has no cause to fear any wind.
Tell me,
say, go see if there is going to be a tea into the tangle and that. There is no cause for the tea to fear any way. When we are deeper, the word of God.
Let somebody shout a big
hallelujah.
Let somebody shout a big
hallelujah.
I mean, I tell you, from start to finish, I've been blessed. I'm going to start from the last statement the preacher made. I want to pick up, want to enter cruise. The preacher said that when a tree, when it has a deep root, it's not but that. About the wind. Any tree that has deep roots. It's not bothered about the winds. Stand up and we'll start praying very soon. Don't stand up. What we are just going to pray for today. I don't want to bother my head about negative things. I want to bother my head about positive things. I want to know more of God. Then the devil will take care of itself. If I know at least 51-52% about God, it's not really a pass mark, but at least the devil has been taken care of. If I have prosperity, poverty is no longer an issue. If I have good health, I don't bother about sickness. If I have the light of God in me, darkness will automatically take care of itself. Very soon, we'll start praying. And like yesterday, we want to speak with our own mouth. Those days in the 80s, we grew up in the 80s. When if you say you're a pastor, Babalawo fears you. My wife told me that if you say you are born again today, the Babalawo in the next street is afraid of you. But these days we have so many powerless Christians. And we are fighting about petty issues in church. I am Anglican, I am Catholic. And the power of God is leaving us. And like God we say in the Bible, it will now move us and it will now go and bring deliverance from somewhere else. It's an insult for you and I to be seated here. God is using one person called Sunday Bo. I don't know if you get what I'm trying to say. Do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
Tonight we are going to be praying positive prayers.
Yes, I know you. How much bad you are that I
do have that. Of 1 million.
If I have a debt of 1 million,
and somebody gives me 1.2 million,
10 grand after me, 1.2
million. The amount of money I'm owing does not matter.
Oh, what is the one day? The amount for coming.
If 1 million devil is disturbing me at night,
1 million issue.
And I have 2 million angels at my disposal.
Yeah, 2 million angels is also me.
Matter. I will never forget that woman.
It's
a woman I can
beat up.
Because her husband is just a general. I cannot put her up. I have to take my hand. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are we ready? Throughout the night from 2 a.m. to like 5:30. I was listening to Archbishop Dawuza.
What
we'll be talking about kidnapping. And I tell myself, God, I'm tired of talking about the God of Elisha. I'm tired of talking about the God of Obalala. I want to start talking about the God of Obalala. I want to start talking about your own God. But if you don't start opening your mouth now,
so bala nisi ko ma je pe a ma wa la so
do na sound like say
ani na na so
me now you open your mouth. He says I will according to the words you have spoken, that's what I want to do.
Saying
God, I have righteousness in my life. I have prospect in my life.
Stop praying it.
I have the angels of God at my disposal. I don't want to be involved in petty nonsense issues again. Issues that is taking me nowhere. I'll be arguing about little things. But when you want the God of God to be powerful in your mouth, you don't just talk anyhow. You don't get involved in petty issues, in little discussions. Let the word of God be powerful in my mouth. First Samuel chapter 3 verse 19 and the Lord was with him. And he did not let any of his words fall to the ground. And the Lord was with her. And did not let any of his words fall to the ground. Use your mouth to call into your life. Use your life to prophesy that good thing into your own life. Use your mouth to tell your mouth, I will not cry again in my life. I will not weep again in my life. I will not be poor again in my life. If you say from your mouth, you don't have it. I will not be involved in discussion that is meaningless. My life will begin to carry for you. I don't want to go and visit the sick. I go and visit the sick. The same way I left that person sick again. I want to go and visit the sick and come out this ministration. That's the level I want to be operating. I'm not praying it now. It may not happen immediately, but it will happen. Keep saying it to yourself. I have light of God in me. I have prosperity in me. I have the light of God that swallows darkness. I have prosperity. Prosperity that swallows pain. Success that takes care of failure. I have upward that takes care of downwards. I have progression. I have peace and I have no trouble again. I have the truth of God in me that there is no more shame. I have the truth of God in me that there is no more nakedness. I have the truth of God in me that there is no more disgrace. I have life in me that there is no more death. I have communication in me that there is no more ignorance. There's no more arrogance. I am humble and there's no more pride. I am righteous and there's no more ungodliness. Start saying it to yourself. When you speak the words, so that your life is better. I have a pure life, so I'm no longer contaminated. I have power, I'm no longer oppressed. I will sleep like baby in the night. I have freedom, I'm no longer in captivity. I have the angels of God and demons don't bother me. I am accident free. Say to yourself. I am that God. This God will be our God unto the end. That God I have victory and no more defeat. No more crying, no more wailing. Say to yourself, this kind of prayer is called wholesale prayer.
Jesus mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
The Lord will answer you in the name of Jesus Christ. You have a testimony before these 40 days fasting and prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. You're coming here every day, will not go unrewarded in the name of Jesus Christ. By the grace of God, be here tomorrow, life and direct with your family in the name of Jesus Christ. That 24 hours miracle will locate you in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Jesus mighty name, we are praying. Please bring out your offering.
Yes, I'm order what daddy.
Bring out your offering.
Yes, I'm order what daddy.
Eternal God of ages, we appreciate you tonight because you are merciful God. Father, we thank you for what you have done. Lord, we appreciate you for what you are doing right now. All glory belongs to you for what you are yet to do. Father, we thank you for the blessing that I have received tonight. Father, we thank you for where you are. Father, we thank you because you are God. Forever and ever, your name remain God. So lift our hands above our head. Oh Lord, in this month of March, speak a word into and transform our life on the level of our children. Transform our business. Transform our Christianity. In the name of Jesus Christ. You will not lack any good things. Mercy of the Lord will take care of you. The grace of the Lord will sufficient for your needs. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Tonight you will see God.
Amen.
You will have personal encounter with God.
Amen.
Whoever has been giving power or authority to comment your life tonight, the Lord will send a word and disappear in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, because you are a great God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.